This is my first video. Thank you and welcome to SKANE Arts, my very first artistic video. I'm going to be painting a poinsettia inside a flower pot. It's going to be a brown flower pot. And I just sprayed the canvas. So the canvas is all sprayed with water. And now we're going to get started. So first we're going to put a background on this. It's going to be blue, ultramarine blue, magenta, and cadmium red, light hue, and a little bit of Payne's gray to make a variant background for our plant. Okay, I'm using a filbert, grabbing a little bit of blue, magenta, red, and Payne's gray, and I'm going to paint varying colors in the background because it is different colors because we want to have. We also want to lighten it up with a little bit of yellow. The plant is going to be red, so we're going to make this a little bit more blue. The plant is going to be red. I'm doing like a crisscross action to put the paint on for the first colors in the background. Ultramarine blue. It's looking pretty already for the first colors. I'm gonna add a little bit of white. Let's get the white. We can lighten it up on one side. We add a little bit of white and soften it up on the right hand side. A little bit of white on this side too. That'll soften it up some. Then we want to go dark again with our three colors. Add some kind of gradient to the painting. These beautiful colors mixed together. Purple, ultramarine blue with quinacridone magenta. This is going to be our first coat of the background. And once this dries, then we'll do a second coat with these same colors. And I'll put a table. See if you can see the table a little better. We're going to use some of the same colors, ultramarine blue, quinacridone magenta and red, so that it matches the wall. But we're just gonna do it sideways. We're doing it horizontal. A horizontal brush stroke with our filbert brush. The beautiful colors. I'm gonna add a little white just to get a little bit of a gradient. And make this beautiful poinsettia flower on this lovely background. Put some more blue, ultramarine blue. Ultramarine blue. We're gonna lighten this up a little bit because we want the light to shine around the flower pot. And using beautiful colors for this painting. And we also want to paint around the sides because the sides are also part of the painting. This is where we are. Thank you for joining me for this first painting. On camera painting. This is where we are. We're painting a poinsettia inside of a flower pot. Should be pretty easy. It's one of the easiest paintings. This is where we are. We're painting the sides because a painting looks really good when you paint the sides of it. So we definitely want to paint the sides. The colors we're using, again, are ultramarine blue, vernacular magenta, white, cadmium red, and Payne's gray. Now on the side, we want to add a little bit more darkness here. It's about to start drying, so we're going to let this dry. We're going to dry it, and then we're going to come back. Okay, we dried it. So now we are moving on to our second coating on the background. Because we want the background to be a little more coverage. So that's why we're going to add a second coat to the background with almost the same strokes as before. This time we're just changing the colors up a little bit, but it's still going to be pretty. It's going to be beautiful even with the slight change of coloring, but it'll look more full, it'll look more covered than it did on the first coat. Magenta and blue and cadmium red together, and a little bit more red. And we're gonna move to the bottom half. We're gonna do a little bit more, a second coat to add. And then in the middle here, we're doing white with all of our colors to add a little gradient to our painting, backing into the parts we already did. Ultramarine blue and white, Payne's gray in the middle. Add a little gradient. Trying to make this background beautiful, but don't want it to take away from our flowers. Okay, some more ultramarine blue, red, and Payne's gray, because that'll bring in purple. You mix it together to give you a little purple gradient. Purple and ultramarine and Payne's gray will give you purple. A beautiful purple color. As you can see, it's a beautiful purple color. Okay, now we gotta add a little bit of white here because we want it to look like it's together and not separate. Right. And we're gonna add a little white down here. The light is gonna be coming straight through here. You see that light? So when the light is coming through here, so that means that the shadow is gonna be on the left-hand side because the light is coming through the middle. And the shadow is gonna be on your left-hand side of the picture. You had all that light coming through the middle. So the shadow is gonna be on the left-hand side. Now we have to do a second coat on our table. Then we're gonna mix magenta and Haynes gray to get that beautiful purple. And a little bit of blue and magenta, and that'll give us that beautiful purple. And you want to add a little bit of more, a little white here, because the light, you want to make sure it's a little bit lighter. And then it's going to be a little bit darker over here because there's going to be a shadow coming from this side. The other side, a little bit light. And I'm going back and forth to try to make us a beautiful table for our flower pot to sit on. So they did a second coat. This is the second coat. On our table. And now we want this to dry a little bit so that we can, I'm gonna add a little bit of light up here. Just a little bit. It won't be a lot. Okay. Now we have to dry again. Okay, so now we are going to draw a flower pot onto our dry canvas. So we're going to start here. Here, drawing the top of the flower pot first. Okay, drawing the top of it first. And we use chalk because chalk can be easily erased. Now, if I want to make this bigger, I can. If I don't think this is wide enough, which I don't, I'm going to erase it and make it a little bit bigger. That's the joy of having chalk. Okay, so this is better. Yeah, that's much better. I didn't like the size of that one. So now we're going to make a slant for our flower pot, and it's gonna meet right here. Flower pot is just sitting inside of a Q-tip. Any excess lines or spaces we don't want. Q-tip. Q-tips work really great cleaning up spots that we don't want. We want to remove it, just use a Q-tip. You can wet it to get it on out the way. If it's not, if you see something on it you don't want in your chalk, it could be easily removed. So there you have it. See how easy that was? Take it right on off. Now we can draw in our plants. First, we need to put our leaves in. So, we want to know where our leaves are going to go. And then our plant is going to be a little bit sideways. And we just draw our plant in. Poinsettia. Know where we want to put our leaves. We know where our leaves are going to go. So we're going to put our leaves in first. And we want one over here. Want that one too big, just want it turned sideways. So we know we want one there, and we want one facing that way up there. And we're gonna have one over here facing this way. Not going to be exactly the way this is. This is just an outline to get us started. Okay, so now we have to decide what color we want our flower pot. I think we're going to make it brown with a little yellow and a little orange in it. So we're going to get our brush and get our brown. Using brown for a base coat. First coat is going to be brown. So we're going to start here. And just paint it on in. Start here and paint it right on in. And we've already started by drawing our picture. So we know where we need to start painting because we've drawn it in already. Sometimes you have to turn your picture upside down to make it, to paint it in. There you go. This is a flat brush that I'm using. Now, the lid, we want to make it a little bit different color. So I might add a little yellow in there. Because we want it to look different than the bottom area of the pot. More brown than yellow, of course. And we just want it to look different than the lower area. So yellow, brown, or you can use a little yellow to make it a different color. And then we have to put in our bottom part of it. You can leave part of the line from your chalk showing so you can know where it separates from the pot, or you can paint right over it. Sometimes it's hard to make the left and the right side look exactly alike. It can be a little tricky. Well, wherever you need to change it, you can always make changes as you go. So the pot is basically covered in with the first coat. Now while that's drying, we're going to put the greenery in. We're going to put some leaves in. First, I think I want to dry this a little bit because it'll be better to work with the leaves if this is dry. So, I'll be right back. Okay, so I decided I'm going to finish the flower pot before I put the leaves in. So, we're going to now use a little bit of orange and a little bit of yellow and a little bit of brown on the left side of our flower pot. And I might add a little bit of white to this too. And I don't want to add too much white. But the light is coming from up there and it's coming down, and light will be hitting the flower pot on this side. Okay. Now we put a little bit more brown. A little bit more brown on here. Now we want to make this a little darker under here because this is the separation between the pot and the top part of the pot. So, want that a little bit darker. I love working with orange and purple. Now we need to get to the bottom part of this pot. Orange and brown. Not as much light is hitting this part of the flower pot. That's nice and shiny. All right, now the other side, I'm gonna use brown and black so that it can be dark. We want it to be brown and black. Sometimes. All right, I'm gonna make it brown and black together so it can be darker. And brown and a little black. black takes over pretty quickly, so you might want to be careful with black, because black could take over. Now don't use a whole lot of black when you're painting with black like this. When you're adding it to colors, because it takes over fast. Alright. Use more brown than black. More brown and black up here. Is this a flower pot? There's nothing fancy about a flower pot. It's just a regular flower pot. Alright, and we're gonna add, wait till that dries. And now we're gonna add a little bit of black, because we need a shadow over here. So we're gonna add a little black and a little purple on this side, because the shadow from the light is hitting this table. So we're gonna put this under here. And the light is shining up from there, so we wanted to put the shadow coming this way, because the light is shining from that way. We want the shadow coming here. Hope you can see this. We want the shadow to be shining out. And on the other side, it will be a little lighter. I'm going to have purple, a little bit lighter back here. Okay, the light is shining, so we need this to be a little lighter, because the light is shining back here. It has the shadow part, but we need a little lighter here, because this is where the light is shining. Be light here on the table, but then it, as it gets over here to where the shadow is, it's dark. You might want to add a little bit more lightness to it. So you can see the light is coming over here from up there, and we want to get it a little bit lighter back there. Okay. Yeah, close as we can to this flower pot. And then some of the light is coming behind here. So I want the light to be back here too. And some of the light is shining back here. So we want to get the light. Some of the light is going to be shining out back here on the side of the table. And then we want to make a little more purple, a little white, and a little red. Have it a little bit. bit lighter purple on this side. This is the third layer to our table. We want our table to be as rich as possible. Many colors as we can get in here. So we put purple, blue, as many colors as we can to make our table as beautiful as we can get it. This is the third layer to our beautiful table. Blue, magenta, red, all mixed together to make for a beautiful table. Yes, a lot of beautiful table. This is our third layer. Third layer. A beautiful purple table. And add a little brown in there. Just to shake. Just to add a little extra reflection from the pot. You want to add a little brown because the pot is reflecting onto the table. So we want to make sure we have a little bit of brown in the table that's reflecting from the pot. We want to add a little light colors down here to add dimension to our table. You have to have light in order to make it the darkness stand out. You have to have light to make the darkness stand out. And we have lightness in the back. We don't want a hard line for our table. So, you know, we try to keep from having a hard line here. So you can just wave your brush in the upward position, and that will keep us from having a really hard line like this one here. We don't really want to have a super hard line, so I'm making a change for that reason. There is no super hard line on the table. I'm doing that with purple and blue. Some beautiful colors. Just adding them in. Just to keep from having a hard line on that side. So add a little bit of light. To the table. I'm going to add a little bit more light to our table. So I'm going to add a little bit more light to our table. Just to give it some dimension. You want to have dimension. You have to have light next to darkness. And add a little orange. Like I said, that's an orange and the brown is helps to serve as a reflection of the flower pot on the table. The orange and brown. That's really a perfect reflection from the flower pot. A perfect reflection. And then the purple and the blue all mixed together. Adds some beautiful color. Okay, so now we are moving on to getting rid of this hard line over here. Not a hard line here either. So, okay, so now we are going to work on our flowers, plants. Okay, so we're going to mix that green with a little bit of black, some yellow. And I have different yellows. I have mid yellow, I have lemon yellow, sap green, and we're gonna make some flower plants with that, some greenery. And also we're gonna use a little bit of black in our green so it can be darker. Okay. Using a Donna Drew Berry brush. This one is a 3/4 inch one stroke Donna Drew Berry brush to make our leaves with a little yellow and a little green. Add a little black to the green so that it can be a darker green. Little black to the green to make it darker. Okay, we're getting ready to add some leaves here. Green, yellow. Alright, here we go. And one, two. Okay, we're gonna have the yellow on the outside. Part of it, and then the second half is going to be turning this upside down so you can see it better. That's one leaf, you can see that. Okay, that's one. Now we're going to make our second one. Little green, little black. We're going to start this with over here. One, two. So this is going to be one, two, three, four. Let's get a little bit more yellow. Four, five. So we got five. And then on this side, same thing. One, two, three, four, five. And now we have two leaves on our plant. That's two. Okay, so Now we gotta do two on the other side. We need one in the middle too. So we need one here. So we're gonna do a little black and yellow. Floating medium helps with the one stroke painting. All right, so now we're gonna make it. We're gonna have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then doing it the other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now each one, we're going to add a little line. A little line down the middle. A little black. Oops. Yellow. And I got a clean brush. And a little black, a little green, and a little yellow. And I'm making another leaf right here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then we're doing it the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then right down the middle. And now you have two leaves. And then we need to do some leaves in the middle. But we want to make those a little smaller, so they're gonna be just small ones, very small ones, some little ones coming out of here, just some little ones floating around. Some little leaves coming out of where the plants, where the flowers are going to be. There's some little leaves coming out. And I make some little leaves. Some little leaves. Just some little leaves. Coming out where the flowers are gonna be. Alright, and then once we dry these, then we will start adding more. Okay, so this one. Now we want to add a little bit of greenery inside here. So we're going to use our scruffy brush to add a little dark green. Dark and light green. So it's going to be dark green and light green. So it's going to be a little bit of dark green. Mixing some dark green. So we're gonna put some dark green in here. Okay. light green in here in the middle, in between the flowers, dark and light green. Dark and light. You may not need a lot because I don't want to have big flowers in there. But you got to make sure you have it dark and light. Not just light, not just dark. Dark and light. May cover up your flowers a little bit, but it's okay because we can always put it back. Alright, now we're going to start adding our flowers. Alright, we got a little bit of dirt. A little bit of dark in here, even though it's going to be a big plant there. Still, I'm going to have it. I'm going to add a little bit of light green in here now, because that adds to the having it dark and light. Is how you get the most realistic when you have dark and light next to each other. So, I'm gonna have it coming down here. Okay, so now we dry this. Be right back. Okay, so now we're going to put in our flowers. As part of it, this is a one stroke flower. That's just, let's put some candle on there. There's one. Doing flower number two. Okay, that's flower number two. Now we're doing flower number leaf. We're actually not doing flower number two. We're doing the leaves. We're doing the leaves. Magenta and white. Magenta and white. This one, magenta and white. We're wiggling our We are wiggling our brush to form the leaves for our poinsettia. Now, we don't want to cover up this whole leaf, so we're just going to do part of it. And then we're going to just add a little bit here, because we don't want to cover up the entire leaf. We don't want to cover up the entire green leaf. Now we're going to do another one over here. That's one leaf. Another leaf. Have to pay attention to that circle, because that circle is what tells us where to put these leaves. Alright, now that's two. Now we have to do a small one. Let me make a little correction here. Small one. This is one stroke. Around. Okay. Okay, now we have to overlap a different one. Overlap one. Okay, so that's three. And now we have to do one more small one. Okay, so this brush might be too big. So we gotta do a small one. Smaller brush. Smaller brush for the small one. All right, so I'm gonna do a left, I'm gonna do a right. Need a little more white on here. Poinsettia leaves in one stroke, and then we have small leaves on the top because you can barely see those. Okay. Now we're done with our leaves and our poinsettia. Now we want to let that dry a little bit. We're going to work a little more on our flower pot to lighten it up some. So we're going to add a little bit of brown and white. We're going to add a little bit of brown and a little bit of white to to lighten up our flower pot, because the light is coming through on the left-hand side. So we just want to add some white and brown to lighten it up. And add more dimension. To add more dimension, we have to have light and darkness in our painting. We have to add that lightness in there in order to bring out the dimension of the flower pot. And after we add the lightness, then we bring in a little darkness on the other side. Alright, I'm gonna add a little more brown. The mid-tone is the brown and white in the middle. And that's the brown and the white in the middle. And then you want to do the same thing to the top. You can add a little white line right here. And that will separate this lid from the rest of the pot. I'm gonna add a little lightness here and a little bit down here. So that we can know where the light begins and where the light ends. On the other side, we're doing dark black. I'm gonna add a little black here. And brown on the other side. And we're gonna add a little light spots over here too, so that just a couple of white spots, not too many. We want to make it look three-dimensional. You have to have the light and dark talking to each other. They have to compensate in order to add dimension. That's how you make your project look real, is to have light and dark talking to each other. That's it. I got a little bit of light, then all the lightness on the left, a lot of darkness on the right, but you still need a little bit of each on each side. Even though this is all dark, I mean, this is light on the left, we still can add a little darkness to it. And even though that's all light, dark on that side, you can still add a little lightness to it to, you know, reflect some of the light. It don't have to be a lot, just enough. Small amounts. See how small amounts make a difference in your flower pot. And then you can add a little bit of sunlight to your pot in a downward position. to really enhance the flower part. And I like to add some very light spots on the end. On the side. Here we go. And then in the back of it, I'm gonna add some more yellow, white in the back with purple to increase the ability to see that this is on the table. So I want to add a little more purple here. I'm going to add a little bit more purple here. And a little bit more lightness on here. Bit more lightness coming around this part. A little bit more lightness. They really brighten this up some more. I'm gonna brighten this up some more. Yeah, let's add a little bit more lightness on this side too. Because this is where the light is shining. From up there. The light is shining across the middle of the painting. So, just want to add as much light as possible around the darkness so that it can all work together. Or realism. Yeah. I said I ain't want a hard line over here, but I might end up with a hard line. I just want this to be close to looking like a real table as possible. And then adding some lightness in here. As much possible light as I can get around its darkness. Now the table is already a purple darkness over here. So I'm gonna add some black around here to add some more shadow to this flower pot. Shadows coming off on the side. From the shower pot, but it's also a reflection coming off in the front of it. So you got a reflection and you have a shadow. So, and we have beautiful flower pot. And now we're going to make centers for our plants. First, I need to dry it. Be right back. Okay, so now we're on to the middle. We're going to do the middle of our poinsettias. We are going to add the middle. First, we're going to start with black. We're going to put black first as the base for each one. So we have black, in the middle. You need more black. Black in the middle. You need to put some water in there. Okay, so we have some black in the middle. Here. And we're gonna put some black here. Alright, that's one side. Now we're gonna wait for that. You want to dry it? The hair dryer. green. Need a little bit of green. Now, this is going to be me, and this one. Okay, now we're going to add a couple more leaves. Green and yellow. These are going to be regular leaves. It's regular. Nothing special, just regular leaves. Nothing special. I want to add some regular leaves in here. Inside. What I'm doing here is trying to determine when I'm going to die. Alright, let's add some regular leaves in here. My family history factoring in longevity, propensity for disease. Regular leaves. Let's see. I think we don't need that many. Just adding regular leaves. Regular leaves, nothing special. Nothing special, just regular leaves. Beautiful regular leaves. Let's see if I can get any more in here. Let's see. Might add a couple more. No gravity's taking over on these leaves, so they have to be pointing face down. Regular leaves. Yeah. Nothing wrong with having regular leaves up there. Okay, so these need to be a little lighter, so I'm gonna add a little extra yellow. to indicate that they are light on the left side. Make this light on the left side. And you have to put lines down a little here. Put a line down the middle. In there. I'm going to start erasing some of our chalk. And just easily erase it with the brush. Erase the chalk with the brush. That chalk. All right, now what we're going to do next to enhance our flowers, we're going to add some dark lines to enhance our flowers. We're going to add some dark lines. That's for enhancement. You don't have to do it. You don't have to. But I just want to do it just to make it a little bit more exciting. Because these are leaves. These are leaves, and they do have lines in them, because they actually, they're petals. They're leaf. They're actually leaves, leaf with petals, and they have veins in them. They actually have veins in poinsettias. They do have veins in them because they are just like a leaf with a petal. So the petals are just like green leaves, but they red. So they do have that vein that goes around it. You can just add something to spruce it up. And these are so small, you don't really need a whole lot. Spruce those up. Okay. And now I'm going to add a little red to my paint, my table, because there's red in the paint. So I'm adding a little red. There's nothing wrong with adding colors to your table, because there is a lot of red coming from the plant. So can add it to your table since there's a whole lot of it up there. It's also green up there. You can add green to your table. I just go ahead on and add a little green. because there is also green in the painting. Green is reflected in your painting. So, you can add green. Also, green can be added to your flower pot and red, because green and red are both reflected. And you can add red and you can add green to your flower pot. There's green and there's red in your picture. Let's add a little white on top of that though. Reflection. So, you're almost done. We're gonna add a few little extra things just for the center of our flower. It's gonna be some unbleached titanium. Bleached titanium to flowers. Bleached titanium. Just to add a little extra. Dimension. And I have to hold my arm in order to do this. I'm gonna cover up all the darkness. And then I'm going to add a little bit of flowers in the middle of the plant. Maybe some white flowers inside. Inside, we're going to add some flowers, some white flowers inside. That always adds a little extra beauty to your picture. To have extra white flowers poking out. Sometimes they spread all the way down. And I have them sticking out over here. I have them sticking out over here. You can have them over here in front of your leaves. Just stick them anywhere. Wherever you want them to go, you can just put extra flowers all over your picture to add to the suspense of it. It adds to the dimension of the flowers. And even add some white in here. You can put these little flowers anywhere you want. Anywhere that you want to put them. You want to put them there. And then on the table, we're going to add some flowers. Adding them to the table really makes the picture stand out. When you add flowers to the table, you can have red, or you can have yellow, or you can have pink, or you can have any color that you want to add to your table. You can add it. You can also add a little bit of red flowers to the center of the plant. Add some red in here if you want. You don't have to. You just leave it white. You want to do that, or you can make them yellow, or whatever color you want. These are one stroke poinsettias, and that's it. That's going to be our painting for today. I hope you enjoyed this painting, and I hope to see you again next time. Bye.